Hello everyone, this is Big Money Chasing Big Money by Copy Trading on BitGet. This video is a step-by-step tutorial about making a full analysis of the master trader's history. The analysis can get complicated at some points, and I know that there can be some sophisticated methods to do all this, like writing macros and VBA codes, but I will keep it as simple as possible so that everybody can follow, even with the most basic knowledge of Excel. By the way, if you don't have Excel on your computer, don't worry, you can pretty much follow the same logic in Google Sheets, or if you want to buy a genuine copy of Excel for just a couple of dollars, check out the link in the description field. The best thing is that you can also pay for it with crypto. Now let's get down to business and select a trader randomly from the first page. This one will be good. This trader has a registration for almost 100 days and has over 500 transactions. Let's see the open trades. Oh, okay, this is not good, but never mind. For analysis purposes, all we need is the history. So what I'm going to do is just copy and paste all the history page one by one. I'm going to select all 10 lines, fire up Excel and paste it. Now, the most important part is that when I'm pasting the copied data, I need to switch to match destination formatting mode. This way, I will get everything line by line, just as it is listed on BitGet. I need to do it for every single page, just copy and paste with matching format. I will fast forward here a little bit, and by the end, I shall have exactly the same amount of lines as transactions, which is 558. And yes, perfect, here we go. Now I have a dataset that I will need to format to be able to analyze it properly. The first thing I'm going to do is select everything and replace the word long with long, but with space after it. This way it will be 5 characters in length, exactly as the word short, and this will make it possible to break these lines accurately into columns. Once it's done, I select everything again and go to Data, Text to Columns. Now a conversion wizard pops up. I select fixed width, and I need to accurately add vertical dividing lines. This way Excel will separate the data into columns. I have now 5 different columns, and the first 4 look great. Column F needs to be divided up some more. So I will replace the word USDT and add semicolons before and after it. Just like this, and hit replace all. Okay, now again, let's go to text to columns, and this time select delimited, hit next, and select the semicolon character as the delimiter. You see immediately Excel recognized the characters in the text and will divide the lines accordingly. Now it's looking much better, I only have 2 more columns to divide. I'm gonna have to add an empty column between column H and I to have some space for the data that's going to be divided. And this time, go to fixed width, and I need to move the dividing line to be exactly between the timestamp and the price. Now I will need to repeat the same procedure for column K. Just separate the timestamp from the rest. Now the last one, do the same. Go to text to column, separate the profit rate from the order number, go to the columns wizard, select delimited, and now the dividing character will be the percentage symbol. To make sure that the percentage format remains, I will just add an empty column here, replace the dot with a comma to have proper numericals, and then divide by 100. I can just click and drag the bottom right corner to apply the same formula to the lower rows, or just hold down Control and double click when the cursor turns into a black cross. Now change the type to percentage and it looks good. Now select all, copy and paste the values to column L, make sure it's a percentage, and done. All right, everything looks snappy. I will just add labels to the first row, and we are ready to move on. Now that I have all the data in the proper format, first thing to do is to arrange the rows from oldest to newest, and from the leverage column remove the letter X. This will be needed for the calculations later on. Okay, remove the filters. Now let's add the columns that are necessary for our analysis. First column is duration, second is base profit, then leverage adjusted profit, then the profit share costs, the transaction fees, and finally net profit. I will need to add some more details here. First, the trader data, save the trader's name, his idea, and his profit share ratio. Now, I'm just going to copy all the details from his profile page. As his follower limit is maxed out, I can't see his profit share percentage, but I'm pretty sure it's set to be 10%. The next set is the user data, which is my budget, my lot size, and my leverage. For the sake of simplicity, I will just enter 1000, 10, and 10. Then I will enter the transaction fee numbers. For normal accounts, the fee is 0.06% for opening and the same for closing the position. If you have a discounted account, it is 0.051%. I hope all of you have it. And finally, the field for net profit. Let's just add some colors to it for better visibility. Okay, this looks nice. Now let's calculate the duration of each position. Just simply deduct one timestamp from the other and I will see how long each position was open. The next step is to calculate the base profit. To do it, simply multiply the lot size with the profit rate. Easy. If I want to make sure that all the other rows are referencing the same cell, I will need to lock the column and the row by adding dollar signs before them, like this. I will need to make sure that the calculations are taking into account my leverage settings. To do this, I will need to divide the base profit by the trader's leverage and multiply it with my leverage settings. Don't forget also to lock the cell value here. The profit share is calculated rather easily, just multiply the leverage adjusted profit by 10. The next step is to calculate the transaction fees. I just simply multiply the leverage adjusted profit by the cell relating to my fee structure. And I must remember to count it twice, as both opening and closing a position means costs. Then I must also multiply it by the user leverage. Finally, I will need to calculate the net profit by deducting the profit share and the transaction fees from the leverage adjusted profit. Apply the same formula to the entire column, and I have a total net profit for this trader. As I have everything set up with formulas, I can easily change the numbers here, and the calculations will automatically update. It works like a charm. Now, the only thing left is to see how much the net profit is by applying the autosum function to column S, and I have everything now. Once I have all the details in a well-formatted way with all the formulas calculating everything for me, I will go to Insert, Pivot Chart, select the range from my first sheet, and hit OK. All I have to do now is drag and drop the fields I need. Let's say I need to know the profits relating to a given day. I will just drop two fields from the list, and I already have it. I am going to expand this to a daily view, make it look bigger. Select a nice contrasting color scheme. I can create a pivot chart to show me the profits per day. In case I change anything in the numbers, with just a click of a button I can refresh the charts, so this is super easy. Now let's see another important metric, which is the positions open per day. In this case, I see that this trader once opened more than 40 positions, which is a big red flag for me. His losing positions are already a big no-go, but seeing that he's also reckless with the number of trades per day, he's definitely up the list for me. Alright guys, I hope this tutorial was useful for you and it helps you in making your own analysis. I will leave a link to a sample file in the description field so you can copy its contents if you wish. You will also find my registration link for discounts. If you already have an account with normal fees, drop me a message and I will see if I can figure something out for you. New videos are coming soon. Until then, trade safe, big money out.